Hey, lovebugs, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my grown, extended, beautiful family, just thank you so much for the love and support that you've been giving yourself as well as me, being able to embrace your gift on every aspect, on every level, knowing yourself more and more every day, and being able to embrace that is a true blessing, no matter how crazy it sounds. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste. Love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please, what are you waiting for? Like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell so you know when your girl's about to upload her next video. Also, I said, also, if you are comfortable enough, y'all, I got stuck for a minute. I said, also, if you're comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I would love a chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback of the content of my video. Or you're just up, tell me about your impact, the gift, and how it impacted your life and heading you towards a positive direction. As well as you feel like if the video is informative to you or just give you some good vibes you would love to share with a loved one, family, or friend, or even a fellow empath that's really truly going through some hard times right now and need confirmation and validation, please go ahead and share. And while you're at it, give me thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. So once again, thank you so much for the love and support you've been sending me. It's greatly appreciated, and I hope you are able to resonate with content of my video. And today I'm listening to Aura Cleansing, Raise Positive Vibrations, 432 Hertz, Balance All Chakras, Chakra Healing. And I will post that link in the description box below. And today my video is about when God says yes, no one can tell you no. Nobody can say no. Because what's meant for you will be for you. You know, when we go through our life, you know, especially after we've gone through our spiritual awakening, you might be, there's something you want in life. You probably wanted to be a real estate broker or a doctor, a lawyer, whatever. You're trying to buy a home, trying to buy a new car, trying to get a raise on the job you're at, trying to get a better job. Whatever you're trying to manifest, and the universe is going to help you get it. And it's just like you'll see signs of anything that you wanted in life. You'll start seeing signs and everything around you. You know, you want to try to find a true love. You're working on yourself. You know, you're working on yourself. You're eating right, which I don't do yet. But I'm, you know, I am doing it, but I ain't doing it as much as I should. So let me retort that. I'm eating the, you know, gradually getting that way. You know, I'm trying to turn vegan again. So, you know, I'm trying to get there. So I, you know, a lot of times I don't eat meat. I will substitute it for some fruit or just vegetables. So I do that. I try to work out as much as I can as well. All these different things, and it's just like God knows what I'm heading for. God knows what I'm trying to do. And it's just like, you know, through my spiritual journey and my spiritual awakening, I've experienced a lot of things. And it's just like I had to go through so much heartache and trauma that I had to have a story to tell, you know, to help other people recognize the things that they're not recognizing for themselves. And I always wanted to be a motivational speaker. So it's just like going through this, it's just like, what am I going to do? Or no, not actually a motivational speaker. I wanted to be able to help save the world. And then it turned out to end up being, you know, because I was set on one thing and then God, you know, converted me over to something else. So it's just like going through these whole situations, being able to use my traumatizing experience to be able to help others see that, you know, even though we've been placed in some really dark places, we are able to see the light at the end of the tunnel. You know, you have to be able to know that, you know, you're not the product of your situation. You're not, just because this happened to you doesn't mean that is you. You know, some people will put you in that aspect, or there's times where it can be so traumatizing, it's hard for you to see yourself out of that situation. But you will. And it's just like when you know you're heading towards something and you're working on your goals, you're working on your dreams. I hate saying the word goals, but you know, it is what it is. Your goals, your dreams, your wants, you know, you manifest these things. You pray upon them. You work on whatever you're working towards to get that. You know, and it's like if you do your part, and you know, it seems like it's going to be hard for you. It's like I tell people all the time, and you should already know, anything you want in life, you truly want in life, it's going to be hard as heck for you to get it. It is. They're gonna, you know, the universe and God want to see, okay, say Sally wanted to, you know, get married. She wanted to find her true love because she's been, every person she has dated, she's had a bad experience on, you know, but God was like, okay, I can give this to you, but how bad do you truly want it? She had to work on herself first, you know, because there's a lot of people that's out here, and I've said that in other videos. There's a lot of people, I used to be that way as well, but then I had to recognize it for what it was. You know, there's sometimes people would love to be in a, you know, be in a relationship just to be in a relationship, to say, hey, I'm in a relationship, you know, oh, I got a girlfriend, or oh, I got a boyfriend, but not really truly having a relationship that's working out, and trying to wonder why all these relationships are failing one way or another, because we didn't give ourselves time to know that person. We didn't, we weren't paying attention to the red flags. We weren't seeing the things that was right in front of our face for us to catch notice, like, hey, it's giving you all type of indications that you shouldn't be with this person. Or, you know, you were just supposed to be in that person's life for a season, and, you know, for a reason, and not for a whole season. And sometimes we put life expectations on seasonal people. So it's just like Sally had to work on herself, work on her mind, being able to decipher, you know, hey, I know my worth. You know what I'm saying? She's been in a very abusive relationships, one after another, after another, after another. But she has took lessons from all those relationships. She never, you know, at first she started wishing, oh, I never met Bob. I wish I never met this person. I never wish I met that person. And then when she starts seeing, this wasn't a curse for her to go through, but these are all the things she had to go through for her to be able to recognize on things that she will not add to her relationship for that one that she truly wants. She will learn there is trust. There was, you had, she had to learn there is communication. There is love. She had to learn self-respect. She had to earn self-worth. She had to learn all these different things, being able to love herself, being able to put boundaries up. See what she had to bring to the table as well as what she wanted to bring to a table. Because, I mean, there's times that people ask me, what do you want in a relationship? You know, and it's just, I really couldn't tell them. I wouldn't know, because it was like I'd never been able to know what true love was. I wouldn't know if it smacked me in the face, you know, at that time, until I found that aspect of my father. He has made me feel loved. I mean, I didn't feel love from my parents. Well, actually, my mom, but she had passed away. But hers was, you know, it was like a oil and water relationship. It got to where I truly wanted it towards the end. And I was really blessed for that. Even though I hated God for that. Like, how are you going to have me and my mom get along so well, the way I've always wanted to since I was younger, and then you take her away from me? But I had to look at it in a positive perspective. My mom didn't want to leave this world with the same attitude she had during her whole life. You know, my adopted father really put her through some mess. So all these different things, you know, I helped my mom out. I did all these things that I had to do. And I was, after I finally stepped back and got out of my emotions, I was blessed for that situation, because at least those last moments I can always cherish. I'll cherish everything I went through with my mom, but I'll really cherish the ending, you know, because me and my mom got very close before she passed away. But I knew, you know, all these different things that I wanted to do for my life, I had to be able to experience this for me to be able to do the things that I'm doing today. Because it's like I always wanted to sit up here and find my way of helping the world have happiness, have love, being able to see the things that, you know, was hard to see. I always been, when I was little, I never knew how I was going to do it, but I was determined I was going to do it. And I had to go through all these different things in my life and be in really dark experiences, really dark places, to be able to say, you know, I'm healing. It's a daily process. You know, I'm not going to say I'm fully over everything, because see, it is like I'm over a lot of things that I didn't think I was going to get over. And that's a blessing right there. Because, you know, when you go through something very traumatic, at that point in time, you're like, I don't know if I'm ever going to make it. I don't know if I can get through this. And it just took time. It just took time. You know, I stopped being focused on that. And it's just like now I just have to stop staying focused on my dad's death. You know what I'm saying? That was a really traumatizing thing, and being able to see the things I really truly didn't want to see. I mean, I've been exposed to things, and I have to say I'm so blessed, because I thought seeing my dad's dead body on the CNN news really pissed me off. I really thought that was going to be the deal breaker right there, just probably blowing my daggone dome off. I really did. But I was able to make it through that. You know, even though my dad was like, I really didn't want you to see that. I was hoping you would not have saw that. You know, I don't want you to remember me as that. Remember me in the good times. Remember me, you know, in your dreams. Remember me in our conversations. But don't remember me as that. You know, and I really, you know, that had to really sink into me. That took a minute. Because it's just like, this year's coming up and I'm like cringing. Because I'm like, what are these fools going to sit up here and do now when it comes to my dad? What are they going to say now? You know, and it was just like a lot of things that I had to go through. But it's just like, this is what I am. This is what made me where I am today. Being able, God led me here. You know, I had to be exposed to a lot of different things so I can be able to heal from it. Because it takes a lot to have to heal from something like that. You know, and be able to be an open book for the world to see. But it's just like, I'm not ashamed of none of the things I went through. You know, if I had to do it again, I'll do it again. But it's just like, I can't sit up here and say, oh, I wish I never did this, I wish I never did that, because that's what I wanted to do at that time. I had to learn, if it wasn't right, I had to learn that it wasn't right, you know, towards the end. But if you know you're going towards stuff, you're going to go through hell and high water. But trust and believe, if it's for you, nobody can't take that away. I mean, I've been in situations where when people found out who I was, either they hung around me because just for the fact is they wanted my dad's essence, and they see that I look just like my dad. So when they conversate with me, you know, I had people, you look just like, and I'm like, are you serious? And we can hang up the phone. You know, we ain't even got to do all that. You know, I used to have people screaming at me like that. And I was just like, that's not normal. You know, I'm like, is this normal? And I was telling my dad, is this how everything is with you all the time? Yeah. Oh, my God. Great. So it's just like, I've had people in my life like that. You know, and they didn't care how they made me feel as long as they had me in their life. And that was a scary situation. But knowing, I'm just like, you know what, I don't need friends like that. I don't need somebody obsessing over him like that, where they want to be able to be attached to me. That's just some weird, creepy stuff. I ain't got time for all that. But, you know, all these things that I had to go through, you know, people, you know, hoping I never meet my family, or people hoping I never get to go Paisley Park. I mean, it was just people just praying upon all those things. And I feel like anything that's for you will be for you. And it's just like, right now I can't concentrate on all that stuff. My dad knows I love him. My dad knows I'm bettering myself. But it's just like, all these things I had to go through, I had to be able to experience this so I can be able to help others along the way. Being able to see your strength when you feel like you're weak at all aspects, you know, when, especially if something has really happened to you in your life, being able to have that self-love for yourself and not being able to just accept anything. I had to learn that a hard way. I had to go the hard knock life, you know, so I had to go through all these different things to be able to be the person I am today. I'm stronger than I ever thought I would ever be. I have confidence in different levels that, you know, I never thought I would be able to have. Being able to have faith in things, even though when days seem dark and things don't see any better, I know deep down in my heart things will get better for me. And just being able to heal and knowing I get those validations every day when I see the things that y'all say about me to me. You know, just being able to know I can be a part of your journey is truly a blessing to me. That warms my heart. Being able to see that when y'all tell me, Roslynn, I wouldn't have been able to know this about myself if I didn't come across you. Or, Roslynn, I thought I was going to end up losing my life until I found your videos. That is a blessing. Even though it hurts my heart that you know, a person was willing to end their life, I was there. I was there a few times because I didn't want to feel the pain. I didn't want to hear the voices. I didn't want to feel all the energy, but I had to go through that. So this is already coming too long. So like and subscribe. I hope you were able to, you know, resonate with this video. But whatever is for you is for you. God is going to open a door that nobody else can't shut. So remember that. So I love y'all. Like and subscribe. Drop me a line. I would love to hear your positive feedback on this video. Give me a thumbs up. Like and also share. And I'll see you on my next video. Peace. Be wild.